Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the rotator cuff muscles.
The rotator cuff is comprised of four different muscles. We're looking at the body from a posterior view at the moment, so from behind, and you can see the first three rotator cuff muscles here. You've got the supraspinatus, the infraspinatus and the teres minor. So now that we've swapped to an anterior view, so looking at the body from the front, we can see our last rotator cuff muscle, the subscapularis, right here. And you can also see an anterior view of the teres minor muscle here, the supraspinatus, and you can just see the infraspinatus as well through this little gap here. So now you can see an anterior and a posterior view so that you can see all of the rotator cuff muscles together. And a good way to remember the names of the rotator cuff muscles is to remember the acronym SITS. So what SITS stands for is supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. So swapping back to a posterior view here, you can see the supraspinatus muscle. And I just want to show you this muscle, as you can see it's passing under this bone here. And this bone here is called the acromion. So the acromion is part of the scapula. Scapula is this big bone here that the supraspinatus is connecting onto the top of. And then as it comes across, it passes under the acromion and connects onto the humerus. So let's take a look at the origins and insertions next. I'll be going through them one at a time. We're going to look at the posterior muscles first. The first origin and insertion is going to be for the supraspinatus muscle. I've highlighted the origin here in red and the insertion in blue. So the origin is going to be on the supraspinous fossa of the scapula. It's going to pass under the acromion here and then connect onto the greater tubercle or the humerus. Specifically, that's going to be the superior aspect of the greater tubercle or the humerus. So the humerus has a greater tubercle and a lesser tubercle. The greater tubercle would be the side which is facing us right now, and it's the most lateral and the biggest bony bump that's on the humerus. Around the other side away from us right here, that's where the lesser tubercle is. You'll see that in just a moment when we look at the subscapularis origin and insertion. Our next origin insertion is going to be for the infraspinatus muscle. That's going to originate in this red area here, which is the infraspinous fossa. It's then going to come across and connect onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. Specifically, that's the posterior aspect of the greater tubercle of the humerus. You'll see it's just inferior or just below the insertion point for the supraspinatus muscle. Our next origin insertion is for the teres minor muscle, and that's going to be originating here, and that's going to be the posterior and lateral border of the scapula. It's then going to come across and connect onto the greater tubercle of the humerus again, but that's going to be on the inferior aspect of the greater tubercle of the humerus. So swapping back to an anterior view, we're looking at the scapula from the front of the body. And usually the ribs and everything else would be obscuring the view of the scapula here. So I've moved all them out of the way so we can better look at the origin and insertion of the subscapularis muscle. So subscapularis would originate in this red area here, which is the subscapular fossa. Then comes across and inserts onto lesser tubercle of the humerus. You remember before I was talking about the greater tubercle of the humerus. So this outer portion here, that would be the greater tubercle of the humerus. And you can see this smaller bump right here, which would be the lesser tubercle of the humerus.
So let's go over the actions next. Now, the primary action of all of the rotator cuff muscles is to stabilize the head of the humerus here in the glenoid cavity. The glenoid cavity is just here, it's part of the scapula, and it's where the head of the humerus presses up against. So as well as being able to stabilize the head of the humerus, all these rotator cuff muscles have other actions as well. And I'll go through them one at a time. We'll start with the infraspinatus and the teres minor, as they both share this same action. This action is going to be external rotation of the humerus, also known as lateral rotation. And that's when the humerus rotates towards the posterior of the body, just like that. The opposite of lateral rotation would be medial or internal rotation, when it rotates towards the front of the body. We'll go over the supraspinatus muscle next. So supraspinatus is just sitting in this part of the scapula right here, passing under the acromion, connecting onto the top of the humerus here. As it contracts, that's going to lift up the arm just like that. So that's going to be known as abduction. So abduction would be this. Adduction, a deduction would be when the arm comes towards the body just like this. Now the supraspinatus is going to be primarily contributing to this abduction movement in the first 0 to 15 degrees of the movement. So 0 degrees would be arm just by your side, 15 degrees would be about here. That's going to be primarily the supraspinatus contributing to that. Past this 15 degrees, this would be 90 degrees right here. That's going to be the deltoid muscle. So 15 degrees upwards, the primary contributor is going to be the deltoid muscle. The supraspinatus is still contributing, just the deltoid is going to be the primary mover in that movement. Let's come around to the front of the body now, and you can see just on the front of the scapula here, this would be where the subscapularis muscle is originating, coming across, connecting onto the lesser tubercle of the humerus. As the subscapularis muscle contracts, it's going to rotate the humerus towards the front of the body. That would be internal or medial rotation, depending how you want to call it. Now, in addition to all of these other actions, you might have seen on other websites or other places, there's other actions of the rotator cuff muscles as well. Now, I've gone through all the research I could find, some of my favorite textbooks as well, to try and verify which actions these muscles can do and which they can't. So I'm just going to include the ones that I have citations for that I could find in the published literature and in textbooks. That action is going to be primarily the teres minor and the subscapularis, and they're going to be contributing to adduction, so adduction, bringing the arm towards the body just like that. So teres minor and subscapularis can assist in adduction, and that's going to be really weak adduction. They're not primary movers in those actions at all, but they can contribute to that particular movement. So if you've enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, let me know what you thought of the video in a comment down below, because it really helps out the channel. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. See you all next time.